follow some methods of writing the elements. Okay, we have actually three, no? The listing method, defining or your statement or rule, and tree diagram. Okay, first term, probability. So probability is the extent to which an event is likely to occur, measured by the ratio of the favorable cases to the number of cases possible. It is usually denoted by letter P, capital P. Okay, it has general formula of small n over capital N, where n is favorable outcomes, and big N or capital N is the total possible outcomes. Kaya always remember, kapag nandun na tayo sa probability, nasa ratio siya, ibig sabihin nasa decimal siya, no? Kapag nasa decimal siya, point something yung answer natin, so wala talaga magsusobra ng 1, no? Because the maximum percentage ng probability is 100%, that's equal to 1.0, okay, sa ratio, no? Now, second term is experiment. Experiment is any process that generates set of data. Some examples of experiment, simple example of experiment are flipping a coin, tossing a die, drawing a card from a deck. Okay? Now, an experiment is said to be a random or chance process if, okay, all possible outcomes are known before it is performed. Okay? Always take into consideration na kapag nag-isip tayo ng experiment, dapat alam natin yung outcomes kaagad. Example, in flipping a coin, if possible outcomes natin is head and tail. Tossing a die has 6 faces, no? So in short, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 yung possible outcomes. Now, drawing a card, we all know na there are 52 cards. Iba-iba, for example, may malunggay, merong diamond, merong espada, etc., etc. Okay? So there are 52 cards daw, no? Different cards. Now, number two, no particular outcome can be predicted with certainty before performance of the trial. It means to say dapat, ano siya, wala siyang bias ba, no? When you're doing the experiment. Okay. Number three, sample space is a set of all possible outcomes of an experiment denoted by S. Again, okay, let us reserve this a variable S or letter S, capital S, to denote sample space, no? Then fourth term, null space or empty space is a subset of sample space that contains no elements. In short, kapag na-encounter nyo yung problem or experiment or statement na walang answer, you always put this symbol, no? This yung parang zero or capital O with the slanting na line. I know some of you already finished tackling null space. Parang meron atang ibang symbol na ginagamit sa null space, but I encourage you to use this symbol. No? Okay, next. You have fifth na term, the events. Okay. Events is a subset of sample space. And last na definition of term is Venn diagram, refers to the illustration of pictures that shows the relationships between events in the corresponding sample space. Okay, this will be our next topic next week. No? Now, let's discuss the methods of writing of elements. Okay, there are three. We have the listing method, defining statement or rule, and tree diagram. Okay, let's open the whiteboard. Okay, na-attach ko na sa ating day 3. Okay, nandito yung whiteboard natin. Okay, let's open this. Okay, nandito ha. Okay. I enumerated 3 experiments. Actually, 4, no? Kasi yung number 2, dalawa yung sample natin dyan. Now, for example, the experiment, you roll a die once. So, how to make a tree diagram? Okay. First, you just need to write S, capital S, then draw the branches. Okay? Branches. Now, remember I told you, okay, here, an experiment is said to be a random or chance process if yung letter A natin, all possible outcomes are known before it is performed. Okay? Known ba siya? Yes, it's known. because alam natin yung die has six faces, no? So it means to say there are six possible outcomes. Open lang natin sa paint para ma-edit ko. Okay? So again, in making a tree diagram, okay, first you write S, then write the branches or draw the branches. Ikompleto natin ito, so dapat meron pa itong 4, then 5, as much as possible, make it more aesthetic, no? Tingnan. Tingnan kasi mag-drawing dito sa paint. But I mean, for example, pwede pantayin yung mga branch, pantay yung haba ng branches, no? So this is a tree diagram for this experiment. Roll a die once, okay? In listing method, you just need to list down, no? You start always with writing capital S, then equal sign, then open brace, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then close brace, okay? Next, we're done with the experiment number one. Statement and rule, okay, let's go back with our handouts. It says here, this method is practical to use if all outcomes are too many to enumerate, such as cities in the world with more than 1 million. In this experiment, okay, hindi siya applicable statement or rule, no? It's because ma-enumerate mo naman siya lahat-lahat, okay? Again, ang statement or rule, applicable lang siya pag marami na masyado. Now, let's proceed with the second experiment, okay? Flip a coin thrice. Okay, again, let's start with in writing capital S. In the first flip, okay, unang flip nyo ng coin, the possible outcomes are head and tail. Okay. What if, okay, ang lalabas sa first flip mo head. So you're required to flip again. Okay? So possible outcomes, head, tail pa rin, no? What if ang lumabas is head? Okay? A second flip. So you need to flip again. Okay? Possible outcomes are head and tail pa rin. So you stop na kasi you're required to flip thrice, no? Tatlong beses lang. Now, it does not mean na marami lagi siya masyado, sir. Kala ko thrice lang. Remember, we're talking about the outcomes, no? The possible outcomes, the probability na mangyari yung isang experiment ba? Okay, isa lang yung possible na mangyari. Mauna mong flip head, the second mong flip head, third mo na flip head. Remember, may possibility pa rin na first flip mo head, okay? Second flip mo tail, then you need to flip again. And the second, the third mo na flip is head. So possible outcome is head, tail, head, no? So, kahit dito pa lang sa first natin, pwede yung possible natin head, tail. Okay? So, pakaintindi daw ng tree diagram natin. Baka akalain kasi ng iba, marami lagi siya, sir. So, di ba, flip a coin thrice lang. Again, I will give emphasis that this means possibility, no? Na mangyari yung isang outcome. Okay, marami. So, kinulang lang tayo dito sa wala ng space kasi ha? Nasa second flip lang itong ating ito sa baba. Actually, dapat meron pa itong head-tail and head-tail, okay? So, in short, okay, the possible outcomes, okay, let's start with head. So, I list down, head. Then, head-head-tail, okay, there. Then, head-head, ano ba yun? May mali. O, tama na. Head-tail-head, okay, there. Then, head-tail-tail. Ito. The same also sa ibaba, okay? Kapag pinagpatuloy natin sa baba, kasi wala talagang space dito sa ating whiteboard, no? Tail, head, okay? Then, tail, head, tail, okay? Again, kulang lang, ha? Then, pwede ding head. Then, tail, head, no? There. Or, pwede din, tama ba yun? Wait lang, ulit tayo. Okay? Tail, head, tail, head, tail, no? Then, tail, head, and tail. Okay. Ito, okay? I don't want to mention the T, no? Yeah, alam ko may matagalog tayo dyan. Ako Tagalog din ako, kaya lang mix na ako ng Bisaya kasi laki ako ng Jensen. Masagwa kasi pakinggan ito kapag binasa mo, no? Okay, yung mga babae, PM nyo nila yung matagalog yun ng mga classmates. Ano ibig sabihin kapag binasa mo ito as letter? Okay. Napaisip yung mga babae dyan. Okay, so ito yung tree diagram ng saan ba tayo? Sa letter A, no? And ito yung listing method sa letter A, 2A. For 2B, okay, the experiment is toss a coin, then roll a die. So that is why the first sub-experiment mo, there are two possible outcomes, the head and tail, kasi you need to toss or flip the coin. No? Now, what if pag-toss or pag-flip mo ng coin, okay, head yung lalabas? So the next, the sub-experiment mo is to roll the die. Okay? So there are six possible outcomes. Okay? Kaya ganito siya. Okay? So the possible na outcomes mo dun sa experiment na yun is to get, okay, so first mo na sub-experiment head, and the second sub-experiment mo, 1 dun sa dial. Kaya we have H1. No? Kung enumerate natin lahat yung sa itaas, okay, H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, hanggang H6. No? The same also sa ibaba, but what if ang lalabas sa first sub sa sub-experiment mo is tail, you need to do the second sub-experiment is to roll the die. That is why meron pa rin siyang 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The possible outcomes is T1, T2, T3, hanggang T6. Okay? So, ito yung pag-list down. Okay. Now, next, last. Okay. What if the experiment, okay, you're tasked to conduct research. Dapat yung respondents mo, taga Notre Dame or estudyante ng Notre Dame. So, using a software, okay, ilagay mo lahat yung pangalan ng estudyante doon sa database, no? So you will use a certain software to randomize, okay, para i-rumble niya lahat ng pangalan, okay? Then you draw a respondent, okay? So that's experiment. So what's the possibility na ilan yung mabunot? Okay? So marami, in short, no? So you cannot do tree diagram like this, okay? Kasi maraming ang branches. Okay, nasa ano ba tayo? Thousands ba yung estudyante ng Notre Dame, no? Kasama lahat ng colleges, so libo-libo. Okay, so mahirap gawa ng tree diagram. Mahirap din ilista, okay? Kasi marami masyado. So mas practical gamitin ang statement or rule, okay? So how to make a statement or rule, okay? Always start with S, equal sign, open brace. Then you declare the variable. Okay, I suggest X na lang para uniform tayo lahat. Then you draw the vertical line, okay? This vertical line means such that, or it is read as such that okay, X is a student of NDDU or Notre Dame Jiangas University. Then close brace. So ganun lang. Okay? Any question? Okay, Alemania, kindly stop the recording, please. We're done.
Okay, sir.